Right, neutralize. Warning, energy levels low.
No quarter! Bleed!
Destroy.
Enemies, dead ahead!
I see them! We are free of them now!
Threat detected ahead!
Prepare ourselves a path!
Leaving combat area. Remain vigilant.
Prepare yourselves for battle!
Come in close!
Threats neutralized.
No more than you deserve!
Destroy. Threats neutralized. You are now safe.
Enemies, dead ahead!
Try to
put it down!
Destroy! Leaving combat area. Remain vigilant.
How very diverting!
The enemy is before us!
I am with you, Highness.
In a town so large as this, perhaps it would be prudent to narrow our search.
Let's start with Dr. Eason, then. I'm betting he'll put us on the right track.
Good idea. I still have to thank him for his help with Maester Felgreed.
from here, on the opposite side. Do you know the way?
Of course. Let us hope Maester Marcus is in.
Pardon us.
Lady Leticia, back so soon. Have you met with Minus?
Yes, and he was good enough to tend to Albaird's arm. Although, he would not even so much as entertain our other request.
Branches oft bend to a persistent wind. So, how can I help the four, three of you today?
Got a question for you. Did you hear anything about a strange shooting star recently?
Oh, to be sure. It was quite the sight. Never seen anything like it. It was all anyone could talk about. Little wonder, the way it scored the skies over Rifle.
Oh, great. So the whole western portion of the kingdom saw it?
Which would mean that the people of Rifle had a clear view. We should check in.
Northeast of the Delvere region. Let's see if the ships are running yet while we're there. I'm so glad Dr. Eason seems to be doing well.
I believe he was overjoyed to see you as well, was he not?
If he was, then maybe he'll fix his bad habit of leaving me behind and running off to dangerous places.
Oh, you are always so worried for Maester Marcus's safety.
How can I not be after seeing him down in the mines like that? Hopefully he stays out of trouble while I'm gone.
Thank you. don't tell me you three are here for a bed at the infirmary, too.
What are you talking about?
Oh, you're not. Sorry. Got a lot of people here looking for treatment, but the sick beds are just about full up.
Treatment for what?
Beats me. Things are weird, I tell ya. First, there's word that the rot's going around again, then that comet. Nothing but ill omens. Easy to see why everyone's on edge.
I suppose our best bet is to start with Dr. Vanel. He may know more than most.
Thank the stars.
Whoa, Doc!
You wouldn't believe the number of sick I've been treating. Please, I need your help.
It is quite all right, Nina. The two of us will be fine. Stay and assist Dr. Vanel. We shall return for you later.
Thanks so much, you two. I owe you one.
I'd rather not distract the doctor now. He seems a touch frazzled.
Then mayhaps the townspeople will have something for us.
Nina will have her hands full with assisting at the hospital. We, however, must continue gathering information. Without proper leads, I am not certain.
Let us question those individuals there.
Excuse me.
I'm telling you, I saw it with my own eyes. Yeah, some nasty goblin man came crawling out of that comet. He's what's been spreading this illness, I tell you.
A goblin? From a comet?
I find that quite a hard story to swallow.
I was out on the wharf when that thing came down. And then, where there was nothing, poof, this weird-looking fellow popped up. I ain't never seen anyone like him.
Care to describe him?
A horn! He had a horn! And his skin is like twilight, all purpley. And now you try telling me that thing ain't the cause of this plague.
A man with a horn came out of the comet.
All right, that's quite enough out of you. Sorry, been out of work so long, not much to do save drink. No, it is quite all right. Channel's meant to open back up any day now. Get us back to sailing. Although these crazy rumors about falling stars and plagues could put an end to those hopes. But really, don't take any of these weird blatherings to heart.
Perhaps we should return to the infirmary.
things looking better here?
A bit. Not that I was able to do much. Anyway, learn anything useful?
Only that there is indeed a great deal of talk. At this juncture, I believe it is safe to say that the whole western half of the kingdom is aware of the comet.
And considering the interest around it, more people may yet try to investigate the crash site. We must move Elena from the shrine as soon as possible. I fear we do not have long.
That settles it. Back to her pod we go. To get to the Galpa Shrine, we have to cross the Larkis region into the Delvir region again.
A significant journey indeed. We should make certain we are properly prepared.
Begging your pardon, but where are you off to?
Delric. And you, sir? Are you a wayfarer?
Oh, something like that. Heard about an odd shooting star in these parts and came to see for myself. You lot seem to have a marked interest in it as well, by the sounds of it.
What?
Couldn't help but notice that orb of yours. Quite a rare specimen. Piqued my curiosity, you see. Enough of this beating around the bush, then. Are you here to retrieve us? Are you here to take us back?
Forgive me, but I do not take your meaning.
I see. Just my luck. And yours is not any better, it seems.
Warning. Warning. Hostile intent detected.
That horn! The rumors were true!
Really hate to do this, but one has to do what one has to do.
Bleed!
Danger.
Not the best.
Should not let it end.
Capable of that!
And we have only just begun!
External temperature rising.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Go. Fire!
Cut them to ribbons. This is the last chance to flee.
Flee? Don't be ridiculous. I want to see more of your tricks.
Dropping.
why you're here. Mind filling me in?
You first!
Are you ready? Here I come!
I need to continue comp destroy.
I was too careless. Here I thought you would just roll over and die. It seems we'll have to pick this up another time.
Attempt to flee, and you will find out just how fast and painful my chakram are.
Easy there. We'll most likely see each other again soon. But until then, I'll leave the falling star to you.
Hold there! Ugh! Blast it! Of all the times! Ugh!
Albert! We must return to the others with all haste. They need to know of this. So, it falls to me!
Enemies, dead ahead!
Now we're together! I see them! Ray, we have returned with ill tidings. Huh? Are you okay? You look terrible!
Blame the weirdo who tried to bust in and destroy Elena before her repairs were done.
What?
With some giant purple-skinned asshole. Who the hell are the people on this rock with horns growing out of their heads?
You guys ran into one too!
I would hardly call our foe a giant, but he most certainly had the skin and horn you describe.
Think our days of taking it slow and steady are behind us.
Perhaps, but for now you should sleep. You may not have another chance for a while. And you look ready to keel over. We shall stand watch for you. We are more than capable. Please, rest while you can.
Yeah, that might be a good idea, actually. All right.
You guys mind waking Midas up before I...
Good night, Ray.
Ray? Ray? It's time to get up. You're awake, finally.
Morning to you too. How are you feeling?
Self-repairs are ongoing, but I'm at least able to operate at 70% capacity. I can move just fine now.
Ah, I slept through your first steps. Some captain I am.
Midas was there for me, in your stead.
Oh, yeah? Thanks, man.
Nonsense. Any doctor or inventor would do the same.
Now that I've recovered, I can assist you. So, Captain, status report.
Now, Chloe's down here. Likely on the other side of the kingdom. We're gonna find her. Leticia and the others have promised to help us out, thankfully. Thing is, I kinda had to promise them something in return. That I'd help cajole Midas into returning with them to the capital.
Your efforts on that front will be in vain.
Midas. Should my system see a marked drop in performance, for some reason or another, It would be helpful to have someone familiar with my schematics besides Rey nearby. That way, any problems that arise could be quickly dealt with.
And if I say no?
Then we would bid you farewell, and that would be that. Were I to require help on my journey, I would seek out a local semiomancer or engineer.
Enough. I'm coming. I've Albert's arm to consider, after all.
You will?
But I'm only accompanying you lot for purely semiomantic reasons. I reserve the right to leave whensoever I wish.
Appreciate it.
Now, as for Chloe, any idea on how to begin our search?
We have heard from reliable sources that Rythel's ports are meant to reopen in due course. And the quickest way to the Easterly lands is by ship through the channel.
Sounds like a plan. Come on, we got a boat with our name on it. Ahoy hoy! Remember me, Welch, the beautiful merchant magnate with genius level smarts? I need something like yesterday. I'll give you the deets in person, so come to my house in Delric ASAP. Do you copy? Ugh, ASAP, okay? Tick tock, tick tock!
Engaging the
enemy. Is the town of Rythel far from our current location?
Yes, to an extent. Rythel is located in Delvir, beyond the region of Rythel.
You need to ask for the Adalia region and the market field.
Unable to accept it. Command.
The enemy leader has been eradicated. We should keep him away.
Stay where you are! Should do it. Stay where you are.
General awareness confirmed. Updating system.
That seemed effective.
Firing!
Keep your distance!
I've weakened the target!
This should do it!
Usefulness. Perimeter secured.
Hostile.
First, we must go through the Idali region to the west.
Prepare yourself.
Get ready. Strong. Make an attack. Neutralized.
Firing.
Destroy.
Us deterred.
By the way, didn't you guys get attacked by some weirdo the last time you passed through here?
We did.
Can't help but wonder, does he have something to do with the people who downed me and Chloe's pods?
It's still too early to tell. Midas, can we be certain that no race of people resembling that man exists on this planet?
No, not 100%. They could very well be natives of some part of Nilbeth.
Nilbeth?
The continent that lies to the south of Asarius. Various and sundry races inhabit that realm, so it is not out of the question that one of them remains undiscovered.
Now that you mention it, since Elena's pod flew over Nilbeth on the way in, maybe someone there saw it and decided to follow her to this continent.
To that point, Nilbeth possesses technology in semiomancy that neither Osirius nor the Vale Empire do. Perhaps a few overweening semiomancers wish to leverage their position.
Let's hope it's nothing more.